Good morning, one and all. Myself, Dr. Swati. The intention of this video is to make the students aware of some of the qualitative tests for the alcohols. So this topic was present in Unit 3 of B Pharmacy second semester course under the subject Pharmaceutical Organic Chemistry 1. So in this video, I'll be explaining some of the general details of alcohols, importance of alcohols, some of the examples, and various classes of the alcohols with the definitions and examples, and also some of the qualitative tests for alcohols. So let us see briefly first what are these alcohols. So the organic compounds which are containing hydroxyl groups are known as alcohols. So if you compare with the molecular formula or general structure of the alkanes, we generally denote alkanes as RH and alcohols as ROH. So where the hydrogen of alkanes is replaced with OH. So there will be one oxygen extra in addition to the molecular formula of the alkane. So the general formula for alcohols becomes CnH2n+2. And one of the important property of alcohols is they have capacity to form hydrogen bonding. Because of the availability of the polar hydroxyl group, they make hydrogen bonds with water. So not only with water, any polar solvent also they will make hydrogen bond. So because of this property of the alcohols, that is ability to form hydrogen bond, usually lower members are water soluble in nature. So let us see some of the examples. So the nomenclature of the alcohols, that is common name and IUPACs, are discussed elaborately in Unit 1. So here I have provided some of the examples based on those IUPAC rules. So the first molecule you can see having two carbon chain, so we call it as ethyl. And OH containing compounds are known as alcohol. So the common name is ethyl alcohol. While in the IUPAC name, the suffix E of the corresponding alkane will be replaced with ol, representing alcohol. So this will become ethanol. That is the IUPAC name for this alcohol. Similarly, three carbon containing alcohol is propyl alcohol and one propanol is its IUPAC name. So here one more example is given. So here, this many carbons are there. So we have to now identify the parent chain which is having the hydroxy group. So 1, 2, 3 carbons having 2 methyl substitutions at 1 and 2 positions. So this can be named as 1, 2 dimethyl. The 3 carbon chain with alcoholic group at first position is called 1 propanol. So this is 1, 2 dimethyl 1 propanol is the IUPAC name for this molecule. And this one is a tertiary carbon containing molecule. So it is an example for tertiary alcohol. So this is called tertiary butyl alcohol is the common name. And IUPAC name, on first carbon it is having 2 methyl groups. And the same first carbon is having the alcoholic group also. So it can be named as 1,1-dimethyl-1-ethanol. So this is the IUPAC name of the molecule. Next molecule, it is a 5 carbon containing molecule with the hydroxyl group. So first one having methyl branching, second one is having ethyl branching. So two different types of the substituents are there. When two different types of the substituents are there, they should be named in the alphabetical order in the prefix. So this will become now 2-ethyl-1-methyl-1-pentanol. This is the IUPAC name of this molecule. So let us see the classification of the alcohols. So this particular classification of alcohols is given based on the number of hydroxyl groups. So based on the number of hydroxyl groups, these alcohols are classified into monohydric alcohols, dihydric alcohols, trihydric alcohols and polyhydric alcohols. So what are these alcohols? What is the difference among these alcohols with examples? Let us see. So the first one is called monohydric alcohols. So the name mono indicates that it has single hydroxyl group. So these are the organic compounds containing one hydroxyl group are known as monohydric alcohols. Similarly, the name di indicates two here. So these are the organic compounds containing two hydroxyl groups. So they are known as dihydric alcohols. So let us see the examples for each of these classes. So here these are monohydric alcohols. All these are the examples. You can see the hydroxyl group may be present on first carbon or second carbon. Overall, the molecule is having only one hydroxy. So they come under monohydric alcohols. And in this example, you can see it is a 3 carbon containing system having 2 hydroxy groups. So they are present on adjacent carbon. So it is called 1,2-diol. The carbon chain is 3. So it is propane 1,2-diol. trihydric alcohol. So these are the organic compounds containing three hydroxyl groups in their structure. And similarly, polyhydric alcohol. The meaning of poly is many. That means these organic compounds are having many hydroxyl groups in their structure. So this is the example for the trihydric alcohol, where the molecule is having three carbon chain with three hydroxyl groups on each of the carbon. So on each of the carbon, as hydroxyl groups are present, we name it as 1, 2, 3. Three hydroxyl groups are named as triol. So this is propane 1, 2, 3 triol. Again, depending on the position at which the hydroxy group is present on the carbon atom, which type of the carbon atom, again the monohydric alcohols, that means the organic compounds which are having one hydroxyl groups, are further classified into three types. So these are nothing but primary alcohols, secondary alcohols and tertiary alcohols. So this particular classification of alcohols is based on the position or based on the type of carbon on which the hydroxyl group is attached. So let us see how we can differentiate these alcohols, primary, secondary, tertiary, based on their structure. So let us see with examples. So primary alcohols. So these are the alcohols in which the hydroxyl group is attached to a primary carbon. So such type of alcohols are known as primary alcohols. Now, what do you mean by primary carbon? A carbon which is attached to only one carbon is known as primary carbon. So in this structure, you can see hydroxyl group is attached to primary carbon. So this is the general form of writing primary alcohol. And rest two examples, the R group is replaced with various alkyl groups. Like here, it is replaced with ethyl. So the name is ethanol. And in this example, the R group is replaced with a three carbon chain, that is propyl chain. So the molecule is called 1-propanol. So in all these examples, the hydroxy group is attached to a primary carbon. So they are called primary alcohols. Secondary alcohols. So in this, the hydroxyl group is attached to a secondary carbon. Such type of alcohols are known as secondary alcohols. So what do you mean by secondary carbon? So here you can see the carbon, this one is attached to two more carbon systems. So this is called a secondary carbon. So here hydroxyl group is attached to secondary carbon. So this is the general form of writing the secondary alcohols. And here is one example given where the R groups, both the R groups are replaced with methyl. So the example is 2-propanol. The common name for this is isopropyl alcohol. So in this you can see the hydroxyl group is attached to a secondary carbon. Then tertiary alcohols. So here these are the alcohols in which the hydroxyl group is attached to a tertiary carbon. So what is a tertiary carbon? Again, this is the carbon where this is attached to three more carbon atoms. So such type of alcohols are known as tertiary alcohols. So in this example, you can see all the R groups of the general structure are replaced with methyl. So this will become now tertiary butyl alcohol. So based on the position at which the alcohol group, that is OH group, is attached to the carbon, they are classified into primary when carbon is primary carbon. And similarly, secondary when hydroxy group is attached to secondary carbon, and tertiary when hydroxyl group is attached to a tertiary carbon. So this is the classification of the monohydric alcohols. So now let us see some of the qualitative tests for the alcohols. So there are two most common qualitative tests, general identification tests are there for the alcohols. So the first popular one is known as esterification test. So the name itself indicates that there will be formation of an ester in this particular reaction or test. So how the test can be done? So if the given compound is alcohol, alcohols have the ability to react with carboxylic acid in the presence of acid. So acid can be any mineral acid like concentrated sulfuric acid. So if the given sample is alcohol, it reacts with carboxylic acid and it gives ester. And esters are having characteristic fruity odor. So as soon as we observe fruity odor, that it gives information that the initial sample is an alcohol. So for the same, the reaction is given, alcohol reacting with carboxylic acid in the presence of sulfuric acid. And this is the esteriform. COO is the functional group present in ester. So that is how there will be formation of ester. And the formation of ester we can identify by observing fruity odor from the reaction mixture. So this is one of the general identification test for the alcohols. And the next test is called ceric ammonium nitrate test. So here, even alcohols having capacity to react with ceric ammonium nitrate. So when they react with ceric ammonium nitrate, they make a red complex. So we will be getting red precipitate if the given sample is an alcohol. So here 2 moles of alcohol react with ceric ammonium nitrate and they make a complex. The alcohol will be making complex with ceric nitrate and with the formation of the ammonium nitrate as the byproduct in this reaction. So esterification test and ceric ammonium nitrate test are the 2 general identification tests for the alcohols. Now previously we have discussed about the classification of alcohols based on the carbon to which the alcoholic group is attached. So they are classified into primary, secondary and tertiary alcohols. So is there any test to differentiate further the given alcohol into primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol? Yes, there is one popular test is there in order to differentiate primary, secondary and tertiary alcohols, and that is called Lucas test. So in this Lucas test, we will be using Lucas reagent. So this Lucas reagent is the combination of concentrated hydrochloric acid and anhydrous zinc chloride. So why, what is the importance of this zinc chloride? This zinc chloride is actually, it is a Lewis acid. It increases the rate of reactivity of the alcohols. Okay, so depending on the ability of the molecules to react with zinc chloride at room temperature. Okay, so based on this, we are going to differentiate primary, secondary, tertiary alcohols. So let us see the test process. So based on alcohol's ability to react with zinc chloride at room temperature, the finally we can say that tertiary alcohols are more reactive than secondary than primary. So how did this particular order given? Let us see with the help of the reaction conditions. So if the given alcohol is a primary alcohol, it does not react with the Lucas reagent because primary alcohols are very less reactive or almost unreactive towards the Lucas reagent, that is concentrated hydrochloric acid and zinc chloride and anhydrous zinc chloride. So there will not be any reaction happens. So whatever the added reagents are there, they will remain as it is without participating in the reaction. So there is no reaction at room temperature for the primary alcohols. If the given alcohol is a secondary alcohol, then keep on standing, they react with the Lucas reagent at room temperature. So what happens? The basic reaction is from the zinc chloride and HCl, the common ion Cl will be replacing the hydroxyl group so that there will be formation of corresponding alkyl halide. So this is for the secondary alcohols. They develop precipitation, keep on standing. Now coming to tertiary alcohols are highly reactive towards this particular reaction. So immediately as soon as the Lucas reagent is added at room temperature, replacement with chlorine takes place and they give corresponding tertiary alkyl halide. So that is how, based on the ability of the molecules, that is alcohols, to react with the Lucas, whether they give immediate precipitation, then we can say they are tertiary alcohols, and if they give precipitation keep on standing, they are secondary, and they do not give means they are primary. So based on this, we can differentiate the alcohols into primary, secondary and tertiary. So in summary, we have seen some of the identification tests and differentiation tests for the identification and confirmation of the alcohols. So the general identification tests are the esterification and ceric ammonium nitrate test, and differentiation test is Lucas test, where primary, secondary, tertiary alcohols will be differentiated. So in the next coming class, we will see about the methods of preparation and reactions of the alcohols. Thank you.